another important potential flow, or elementary potential flow, is called a line source. And this is basically a line, and we'll give it coordinates here, x, y, and then we'll say z is aligned with that line. And basically the line source would have flow emanating out from it, perpendicular to the line itself. The way we write this velocity potential in, and we do this in cylindrical coordinates, so as a function of r and theta, it's equal to lambda over 2 pi times the natural log of r. And so now if we take the gradient of phi, that gives us velocity, so del phi. And if we do this in cylindrical coordinates, we would get lambda over 2 pi r in the r direction plus 0 in the theta direction and 0 in the z direction. So there's a couple things we can look at here. So notice that this equation has to solve continuity. So that means that as the flow moves away from the line source, it actually has to slow down because there's no component in the theta direction or the z direction. So all the velocity is in the r direction. And so so we see here that the velocity is equal to some constant lambda over 2 pi r. Now, lambda tells us the strength of that line source, but you can see that the velocity drops off as 1 over r. You can see that in this term here. The velocity will decrease. So if we were to plot the velocity as a function of r, or I should say velocity in the r direction, it has a 1 over r relationship. Another thing we learned here is that there's a singularity at r equals 0. So along the center line here of the line source, the velocity is infinite. We actually cannot compute the velocity at that point, but we can look at the velocity at every other point in the flow, just not at that singularity. But this equation, this velocity potential, satisfies Laplace's equation and is one of the elementary flow elements that we can use in constructing more complicated solutions. I'll also point out that if lambda is less than zero, then it becomes a line sink. And that satisfies this Laplace's equation as well. So so we can have velocity emanating out from this point or coming into this point, and either way it can satisfy Laplace's equation. Lambda will be positive if it's emanating out and negative if it's a sink, if it's coming in.